In the recent episode of Hell of a Boss, we learned that there weren't just seven rings of hell, but also nine circles. And while I believe Vizipop added these new details in so that many people would be less confused, I noticed a lot of people still don't quite know what's going on. So today we're going to break down the differences between the seven rings and the nine circles of hell. My name is Deepcut, welcome back to Cartoon Universe, and I know you're already subscribed because you're a really cool person, so I don't have to ask you to subscribe. Right? Now, how did we get here? Hazbin Hotel and Hell of a Boss both, of course, take place in Hell. Back in 2019, the Hazbin Hotel pilot first came out and introduced us to the world of Hell with its red sky. At that time, we had no reason to believe that Hell was anything more than what we saw. We knew that there were other cities and other landscapes outside of Pentagram City, but it seemed to be just one cohesive land or world. It seemed that early on, Vizipop knew that she wanted to try and shop Hazbin Hotel around to a TV network or streaming service to make a legitimate series, but still wanted to produce an indie series that could hold the attention of the Hazbin Hotel fanbase. Originally, a lot of the story of Hell of a Boss was meant to be included in Hazbin Hotel, but between needing a different show to produce for YouTube while shopping around Hazbin Hotel, as well as Hazbin Hotel already being overflowing with really cool characters, Vizipop decided to take these characters and give them their own show. Fans have noticed Blitz in the background of the news broadcast in the Hazbin Hotel pilot, and even Moxie can be seen in the audience at one point. One lesser known detail I learned thanks to one of my friends on Discord was that Stolas appears to have been in early drafts of Hazbin Hotel as well. Before the pilot was released, Vizipop would put preview clips on the channel, including the montage of Alistair overthrowing the Overlords. In an early version of a shot of all of the Overlords, we can see a character that looks a lot like Stolas, with just different clothes. In the official pilot, he is replaced by a different demon with two faces, though still with that owl theme. For those wondering why Millie and Luna seem to have the least subplots within the show, they seemingly were not part of the plan for Hazbin Hotel, and were only created to fill out the cast when Hell of a Boss was created, which already had its plot lines planned from Hazbin Hotel, though I imagine we will get more development for these characters as time goes on. Simply giving the characters their own show could prove to be a bit dangerous though, as a lot of Hazbin Hotel story seems to hinge on its lore. While it is possible I am wrong and that Vizipop always intended to have seven rings of hell, it would seem to me that she invented them only when she started making Hell of a Boss its own show, allowing the characters to explore parts of Hell and its lore without interfering with Hazbin Hotel's lore. This is likely why they came up with the rule that sinners are only allowed to exist in the Pride Ring, so that they can safely explore different plots while technically existing in the same world. A lot of fans were confused about why there were seven rings of hell, because in the Hazbin Hotel pilot, Katie Killjoy makes a passing reference to the nine circles of hell. Katie Killjoy did not reference the circles of hell as something that definitely existed, but rather in an expression of disbelief. She said, "What in the nine circles of hell?" the same way one might say, "What the hell?" This was a reference to the real-life epic poem known as Inferno. In it, the author describes nine circles of hell that exist, each one representing a different sin, with the exception of the first circle, which is simply a place of limbo for people who are good but did not accept Jesus Christ as their savior. At the time, we had no reason to believe that this was a reference to anything literal, and seemed to just be a joke thrown in for fun. When Hell of a Boss eventually revealed that there were seven rings of hell, however, this led to a lot of confusion in the fanbase. Some fans even insisted that they believe that there will be more than seven rings of hell, and that it would be nine, just like in Inferno, but I personally wrote it off as a simple joke thrown into the pilot that wasn't intended to point to any lore. In the most recent episode, however, we saw a sign in Imp City that claimed that it was in the second circle of hell. So what exactly are the circles, and how do they differ from the rings? Well, the seven rings of hell seem to be separate worlds that are all stacked on top of each other in some way, with the Pride Ring being at the top. Each ring represents one of the seven deadly sins, and is represented by one of the seven demons, based off the real-life classification by Peter Binsfield. Through each episode, we got a little more information about each ring and their differences, and have a pretty clear idea of how they operate now. The top ring is the Pride Ring, which has a red sky. This ring is ruled over by Lucifer, who also serves as the king of all of hell. It is only here that sinners are allowed to exist. Beneath that is the Wrath Ring, which has a bit of an orange sky, though the haze can make it hard to tell. Satan is supposed to be the prince of this ring, though he has only been mentioned in passing so far as a sort of deity, similar to Hell's version of God. Third, we have the Glutton Ring, which should come with a yellow sky. The prince of this ring is Beelzebub, who Moxie refers to as a woman in the recent episode, indicating that this prince may be a princess instead. Fourth, we have the Greed Ring, which in episode 2 we saw had the green sky. It is ruled over by Mamon, who we can see is printed on Hell's currency. Due to his jester design, some fans speculate that jester-based demons come from the Greed Ring, though we don't see any here and instead just see lots of imps at Lululand. Fifth comes Lust, which we recently saw had a dark blue sky, and is ruled over by Osmodius. We do see some jester demons here, though like Moxie and Millie, they may just be visiting, so we don't know which ring they come from. Six, with a purplish sky, should be Envy, ruled by Leviathan, and the bottom ring, with a pink sky, should be Sloth, which makes sense that the sin of Sloth would be at the very bottom. The Prince of Sloth is called Belphegor. While these rings are said to be stacked on top of each other, we do not see the bottom of one ring hanging over the other. In fact, the sky looks completely clear, and stars can even be seen at night, as we saw in the Greed Ring. Some fans believe that they aren't physically stacked on top of each other, but instead are metaphysically on top of each other, but the use of an actual elevator to travel between the rings seems to indicate otherwise. Now, this setup of rings stacked on top of each other is very similar to what Dante described in his poem Inferno, but with Hazbin Hotel itself, the nine circles seem to refer instead to nine geographic locations within the Pride Ring alone. At the very center of this, the first circle, appears to be Pentagram City, and the area surrounding it. Beyond this border would be the second ring, which includes Imp City, which is in the Pride Ring. A lot of people are constantly confused by this, so I really want to emphasize this. The Pride Ring has a red sky. Both Pentagram City and Imp City are in the Pride Ring. This is why Blitz and the Imp Gang can talk to sinners. They travel to other rings for trips, but they live and work in the Pride Ring. Sorry for over-explaining, but even in videos where I explained this before, people really seemed confused. As for the other seven circles of hell, we don't know what they include, but they likely continue to just expand outward, with each circle of hell just being a larger radius around the circle before it. While some fans may want to think that these circles also represent their own sins, I don't think that is the case. Vizipop has explained that people in hell tend to live around others who shared their experience in life, with entire towns existing just to maintain what life was like for demons who died in a particular time and place. There is an entire town we see in the Alistair comic, for instance, that is meant to look like early 1900s America. If people come to this town without trying to fit in with the 1900s culture and style, other demons will immediately cannibalize them. While sinners are not able to move between the seven rings of hell, it seems they are able to travel freely through the nine rings to find the kind of town that they will fit in best. Some fans speculate that all seven rings will have nine circles within them, but we have seen no evidence of that yet. We only just learned about the nine circles from the Imp City sign, which originally just mentioned the year that Imp City was established. So it feels to me that Vizipop saw fans were confused by the seven rings and nine circles, and added nine circles to the Pride Ring in an attempt to make both canon. But who knows? Perhaps the show will explore these nine circles at some point and reveal it was all part of Vizipop's plan. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, as well as let me know anything I may have missed, and I'll see you guys next time.